Marvell Technology Group recently had their Q3 earnings. They announced a big acquisition, a semiconductor design startup called Celestial AI. There's a lot of development going on in optical and silicon photonics for AI data centers. So we did a CSI Live update on this topic. What follows is an excerpt from that live event. Marvell Technology Group.
And if you want access to live events like this one, as well as all of our research and a community of like-minded investors, check out chipstockinvestor.com, where you can get access to that membership. See you all over there. Let's get started. We haven't done a lot with Marvell lately because it's a company that we no longer have in our portfolio, but we have still continued to watch it.
Yeah, and to be fair, we consolidated into Broadcom, but I think there's a video on YouTube with your face on the front of the YouTube video where we said if you're looking for a good buy in custom silicon and networking, Marvell was looking pretty good. That was 3 to 6 months ago.
I was actually getting to that.
Oh, you were? Okay.
So I think that the blog article that we wrote was back in June, outlining some of the issues that they've had. Their acquisitions had taken a toll on them. The company's valuation had changed a bit. Let's start from the top. Fabless chip designer in the semiconductor industry, Flow, and their main competitor. We're going to show you a long list of competitors, but we like to refer to Marvell as baby Broadcom for a reason, that Broadcom is one of their biggest competitors.
Nano Banana was working sort of today. So here's your earnings snapshot slide. We're not an earnings coverage show or hot takes on the numbers, but here's a snapshot of what happened. Revenue growth was 37% year-over-year. Or when factoring for the sale of the automotive Ethernet business to Infineon, up 41% year-over-year in Q3. And of course, AI data centers were the big mover for Marvell this quarter. No surprise there.
What it looks like is on this chart that quarterly earnings are now completely commoditized by Nano Bananas, complete with great visual.
If it's in a good mood.
If you prompt it exactly correctly. So here's the summary for Marvell in Q3 fiscal year 2026. This is their end market breakdown. And I don't know about you, but I found this chart slightly confusing because they have data center and communications and other at the top. And what that means, the communications and other is now broken down further into the bottom: enterprise networking, carrier infrastructure, consumer, and then automotive and industrial.
And I don't know why they listed data center a second time. That made it extra confusing. But the point here, excluding automotive and industrial, it's down year-over-year because partway through the quarter is when they actually divested it to Infineon. That's why that says negative 58% year-over-year on that line. So just ignore that for now. If we look at our end market slide, what we have been waiting for all year was a more pronounced uptick in growth in cloud and enterprise, and then also auto and industrial, which we've talked about recently in other videos and live events. But cloud and enterprise has finally hit a new growth cycle. It's still not a huge inflection, but it is joining in on the accelerated computing super cycle, finally. So this would be like traditional cloud computing and more traditional enterprise. Some of it might be just good old-fashioned on-prem, a company's private data centers. If we go back to the previous slide, be it traditional cloud, enterprise, carrier infrastructure, that would be like telecoms, internet service providers, communications networks, we have finally returned to growth mode. We're in a growth cycle across the board in the semiconductor industry. So that's where we're at right now. That's the good news. We are headed into 2026 in a position of strength with most of the end markets either just beginning or in the midst of a growth cycle. Okay, let's move on to Marvell's outlook.
Okay, in yellow, we have highlighted their revenue expectation for Q4. $2.2 billion, which implies a revenue growth of 21% year-over-year. And then we also highlighted in pink their diluted net income per share. And on the right side, that's on a non-GAAP basis, plus or minus 79 cents. Earnings per share growth on a year-over-year basis of 32%.
And why that might be helpful right now, if it pertains to you as a Marvell shareholder, is because of the divestiture to Infineon. Marvell is realizing a taxable gain on that sale of its automotive Ethernet business. So the GAAP metrics are going to be wonky as a result. So the non-GAAP adjusted metrics help you get a better year-over-year comparison. And then also there's another acquisition that Marvell just made that'll also skew things a bit starting early 2026.
As Nick mentioned at the beginning, we're going through all of these portions of the computing system, the three main parts of the computing system: logic, the CPUs, the GPUs, the XPUs. That's where all of the thinking goes on. The networking, that's primarily what we think about when we're talking about Marvell, moving information between different parts of the network, between those logic chips, data storage from memory, back to logic, and everywhere in between in a data center. And then storage, that's where we're going to talk about pure storage, where all that data is stored, waiting for processing. And all that's important to understand because Marvell has a huge competitor base, especially now that they've started focusing on data center infrastructure.
So Broadcom is the big one, but so lots of competition here. Intel getting in the fight with the partnership with NVIDIA. Alphawave in process of being acquired by Qualcomm. That'll make them a competitor in this field. Of course, Astera Labs and Credo. This field of competitors in custom silicon and custom networking is going to likely change a lot in the next few years. And Marvell itself is going to change a lot in the next few years too. And let's talk about why that is. Their biggest customer in custom silicon in XPUs is Amazon AWS. And this is pertinent information because this week, Amazon AWS is having its reInvent conference in Vegas. And they announced that they are going to be supporting NVLink Fusion, which is NVIDIA's answer to the custom silicon market that Broadcom and its IP and design work with Google on the TPU starting over a decade ago really helped kick off. So now customers that want to design custom silicon for very large workloads that they have can now continue to build within the NVIDIA ecosystem. And Marvell is part of this ecosystem. They are part of the NVLink Fusion network, and AWS is supporting in that. And that's relevant to Marvell because now two of their design partners and ultimately AWS cloud customers can now get access to this infrastructure.
Seems like a circular relationship.
It's absolutely circular.
Everything
is a circle.
We've got a wave in this slide. This illustrates the relationships and how a basic or application-specific integrated circuit, or as called an XPU by Broadcom and Marvell, gets made for a company like Amazon. Marvell does the IP and design work. We also have Alchip listed there because that's a possible encroachment on their XPU design with Amazon. Amazon wants those custom silicon devices because they have specific software that they're using it for. It's manufactured by a company like TSMC, and then it gets installed into Amazon AWS data centers. This is just an example. There's a lot of other companies that are doing the same thing and getting custom design work. But that leads us to the newest acquisition for Marvell, Celestial AI, which is not an AI chatbot.
It is a startup founded in 2020. So a pretty new company that suddenly is going to be purchased for upwards of $5.5 billion if these certain revenue milestones are reached through fiscal year 2029, which for Marvell would be January of 2029. They think they're expecting somewhere in the range of $500 million to upwards of $2 billion in revenue from Celestial AI by the end of fiscal year 2029. So pretty wide range of outcomes here. Either way, it's a pretty expensive price tag. They're going to spend $1 billion in cash upfront to make the purchase and then issue $2.25 billion in Marvell stock. It's a bit dilutive, but the market cap is currently roughly $80 billion, so it's not a huge dilution event, but you can see the possible upside here. If within a few years, this thing is generating incrementally $2 billion more in sales, this could be a really good purchase for Marvell. They're going to finish the deal by the first quarter of calendar 2026. So this is going to get done pretty quickly.
But can they afford it? Let's look at their balance sheet.
There's the cash on balance and the blue bar. That's from the sale of the auto Ethernet business to Infineon. So $1 billion of that is going to go away in Q1 calendar year 2026. Still elevated debts, but the balance sheet is in pretty decent shape. They've improved a lot since the depths of the bear market over the last couple of years. So that's good. Let's talk a little bit about what Celestial AI actually does. Everything in gray is what Marvell already designs on the networking side, data center networking, including for AI data center networking. On the left is their switching portfolio. Switches are the chips used to connect different components within the same network versus a router, which connects different networks to each other. So a lot of this is to scale up existing networks. And in blue is this photonic fabric, or PF. You'll see the acronym here in following slides from Celestial AI. What does this do? There's the scale up illustration of scale up, adding more compute density within a server rack. And those little blue bars within the server rack is these PF switches, photonic fabric switches that they'll begin designing using this Celestial AI IP. And then scale out is adding more racks to each other. So connecting these racks to each other to create one big AI data center network. So pretty powerful IP. Here's a closer look at some of this IP, the photonics input and output. It can be used to connect within the chip itself and within the package itself. So very small, die to die, chip to chip, or die to chiplet, all within the same package, or connecting package to package and package to fabric. So the IP is quite extensible. Photonics is quite powerful. And the hope here is that a lot of this will help break down some of the bottlenecks, especially between chip to chip and memory to logic parts of these data centers. And then one more here, real briefly on the right, OMIB, optical multi-chip interconnect bridge. So this is a customer like Amazon AWS, has multiple XPUs that need to be interconnected with each other. These little circuitry designs can be used to do that, to interconnect them. And then also connecting it to perhaps a memory module, for example, in tandem with what we're going to talk about next with Pure Storage. So helping increase the bandwidth between memory and logic parts of the data center. A lot of uses for this Celestial AI IP, and thus the very high acquisition price, a very broad range of possible revenue outcomes in the next 2 to 3 years. But this is why they're dropping upwards of $5.5 billion on a semiconductor startup.
So at the very beginning, you mentioned that we've all been wondering about a slowdown or a cyclical downturn, and that could be happening. So let's talk about that, not only with Marvell, but something that the CEO of Credo said.
There's a lot of changes possibly coming to these network architectures in the next few years. A lot of companies are working on new technologies to help boost the performance beyond what is currently possible. We mentioned Credo and this quote from Credo CEO talking about the ALC, active LED cables. This is another optical product, but instead of silicon photonics, this would be a different type of optical technology for networking. First samples of this coming out in Credo's fiscal 2027. So that would correspond with second half of next year and into the first half of 2027, with revenue ramping in fiscal 2028. And we can compare that with what Marvell just said with this Celestial AI product revenue kicking in their fiscal 2028, which would correspond mostly with calendar year 2027, roughly in line with what Credo just said for this new product. So what does this mean? Even though accelerated computing is huge, it's addressing multiple markets at this point, it's still hardware. And so you're still going to have hardware cycles. And we actually had one last year. Remember when NVIDIA was ramping up the Blackwell platform with TSMC, we actually got a cyclical slowdown. It wasn't a cyclical downturn, but growth actually had slowed in the top line of this accelerated computing end market. Now that Blackwell has started rolling off the manufacturing line, we updated this chart at the beginning of the year for a re-acceleration of growth in this market. And we expect that to continue into the new year. But at some point, perhaps around mid-year 2026, the hyperscalers might start slowing their spend as they await next-gen networking products. We also don't know what comes after Vera Rubin from NVIDIA next year. And so maybe our next cyclical slowdown will start the second half of 2026. This is maybe our first hint. It's going to be driven by technology rollouts and the roadmap for these companies, but this is perhaps the first sign that we'll start to have a slowdown second half of next year. A lot of things can inform your decision-making and ultimately is going to be driven by what your personal need is for your portfolio. But I think this is relevant information for everybody. Obviously, you're here because you're a long-term investor in semiconductors, as well as a lot of other technology. So here's some food for thought, something to start chewing on as we enter the new year.